The others wouldn't let me join them for the fight. You should get moving, though. They'll need you at their side.
It's a good thing Leia's safe back at the cave. Seeing all the dead seekers like this could break her.
Kerbin stares at the body of his dead comrade, tightly gripping his weapon in a cold fury.
Magisters, I'll kill everyone that I see, slowly.
Doesn't feel quite right, but I need all the equipment I can find.
You don't remember? Goodness. One moment my flesh was flaming with cursed fire, and the next you had eased my pain. I can't tell you how grateful I am for your kindness. Now I'm just trying to get used to life as a pig. It's not so easy. I never did enjoy truffles. Well, I can trace it all back to Bracchus Rex, of course. Many of us opposed his reign. Few dared to speak against him, though. A few of us wizards took the chance, though. We figured if we spread the word of his deeds, we might encourage enough people to come together, find a way to take him down. But we underestimated the cowardice of our comrades. All we succeeded in doing was being branded heretics and brought to Bracchus Rex's court. The results were horrifying. A double curse, turned into pigs and set aflame for eternity. I like not being on fire, so I don't want to complain too much about the pig part. I'm not sure. I have prayed to Armadia, but she offers no answers. Really? There must be a shrine there. If anyone can restore me to my previous wizardly self, it's Armadia. I'm so grateful for this news. I'm going there now to seek Armadia's blessing. Thank you. Thank you.
Frozen ground in the middle of the swamp. What's going on?
Unreadable glyphs mantle this ancient pillar. Braided through thick iron rings, source-infused chains bind the dragon tightly.
A winter dragon? What on earth is it doing chained up here?
Unreadable glyphs mantle this ancient pillar. Braided through... The earth with icy claws, quakes from the impact knock you back. The freed dragon looks sick and pale. As you approach, he stretches his tattered wings weakly and fixes his intense gaze upon you. Frozen tears glint in his eyes.
My gratitude for your efforts, friend. Yet I am no more free now than I was in those chains. Please. Help me find true liberty, or sing me to the endless slumber. But of course, that must be why you stand before me. Slain called to the Lord of Death, and here you are. A coincidence. My fate, it seems, is not my own to call. My soul is bound to joyless obedience. Purged of my source by the wickedest of witches, I stand enthralled to her every whim. She has only to command, and my traitorous body complies. The witch Rudecca. I was in love with her once. For the smallest slight, really a trifle, she wielded a purging wand against me, enslaving me to her will. Now only my voice remains my own. She trekked far underground beneath a nearby tower, seeking ingredients for her vile potions. I can feel her dark heart beating within my own, even from here. I await her return, yet I would prefer to welcome death from the sight of her face again. Allow? I did not choose this. As I am quite sure, you did not choose any number of indignities in your own life. Least of all, your presence on this hellish isle.
The dragon sniffs and rakes at the ground with one razor-sharp talon.
A thought cannot mend a soul. A prayer cannot heal what has been ruined. You talk to soothe yourself, not me. That you would even ask such a question of a stranger already in your debt. There is much goodness within you, but this task would not be easy. Rudecca is a canny one, cat to your mouse. She consumed all my source with her purging wand. So long as she holds it, she has absolute control over me. If you could retrieve it for me, I could be free again. You would have my gratitude, and whatever aid I can then offer to you.
Lucky find.
The goddess's tears still stream freely, but an aura of loving calm now permeates the soft, moist air.
Thanks for sending me here. It's quite beautiful, isn't it? I've prayed to Amadia real hard, but I'm not sure it's done much good. Still, a wizard trapped in a pig's body. Any ideas? Do you suppose? Well, I guess it couldn't hurt. At the very least, it's nice to have good company.
Speak if you wish to.
The goddess's tears.
Thanks for sending me here. I've prayed to Amadia real hard, but I'm not sure it's done much good. Oh, what a grand idea! I'll try that. What's the worst that could happen?
With Amadia. Oh, I'm a wizard. And I was a long time ago, too. In between, I was a pig. And I was on fire for most of that time. It's a long story, but I think I'll leave it in the past and look to the future instead. Of course. Bye now.
What's this? It looks...
fooling me?
Strange. Are my eyes fooling me?
A tall woman stands amid a field of corpses, some fresh, some ancient. The sour smell of them stings your nostrils, your eyes. As you draw nearer, the stench blooms into a humid flavor you can almost taste. The woman turns to you, bitten lips parting into a grin. She tucks a small bunch of black-red roses into a leather strap across her left hip and, preparing to curtsy, offers you a hand.
What a ball.
She stands to her full height, her lips pursed in disappointment. She cocks her head and takes you in. The stench of death and sewage suddenly intensifies.
Now, now, that's enough of that.
Ave de more de mea galach. Very good, kitten. Now, I imagine you're here for the same reason I am.
She pats the bouquet at her hip.
But you're too late. These roses belong to me. Looks like we'll have to find some other way to keep you busy. Oh, I do hope that little so-and-so hasn't been talking. Those chains were in a place for a reason. Ha! How earnest you are. I do love that in a man. Then I suppose you aren't leaving, darling.